to my name. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Thanks for the good you've been doing to me. Hey, Radia, now my mama see.
Okay, I pay 97. Boys are by heaven. I charm in the hits. Less the leggings. Tight. Maintain. My legend. Nice. The free fear. My bed in. I pay 98. And land crash setting straight. Hip life. Your median. T.O. Be are you late? Now papi could just so I went out the retail. My jinchi. My son. Now by hits. He repay. I pay me right. The pass it. Papa. Force it. Papa. Papa. Share GD. Now papa. Back up. Me slow. Piano. My cote. Baby. I run. Me papa. Rapper. Daka. Now me clatter. Shasi. Before. Kill. Kumante. Not the Lord. Kenya. Me kaki. 1999. Yeah. GGMA. 2000 we talk for USA. Apollo the Seahawk we first play. Where would you radio? Yeah, you just say.
Hey, just a mint.
Very well, good morning and welcome to yet another edition of Good Morning Africa. We're live on Pan-African Television, truly African. It is the 8th of February 2017 and definitely we thank God because we're all alive and we're awake and we're kicking and we must definitely be happy about it. Now, let me assure you this morning that definitely you're going to have a wonderful morning because of the kind of programs we have for you. Segments actually that we have for you this morning on Good Morning Africa. Now, if you watch Pan-African Television a lot, I'm sure that you know now that on Saturday we're going to be having a very wonderful play here dubbed In a Bag of a Woman, and it's originally written by Oswald Okaite. We're going to be having that on the premises of Pan-African Television, and is at Abelinkwe. So, you know, just ask of AMA Submetro in Abelinkwe, and then we're just next to AMA Submetro. Make sure that you come in and join us. It's free. Open to all. You can just walk in. Let's have a good laugh on Saturday. And definitely, we're going to also make sure that on the 14th of February, we'll bring you an exciting program for the Valentine's Day. This is Good Morning Africa. My name is Kwame Owusu-Danso. So let's go and check these songs out. We'll be right back.
There was every reason to have the flags out at Westminster. They welcomed delegates to the Commonwealth Prime Minister's Conference. Then came the news of a united attempt to seek peace in Vietnam. President Nkrumah of Ghana will be in the peace mission. And coming out into the garden now, Mr. Shastri of India, Premier Wilson with Dr. Banda, Malawi, and Dr. Obote, Uganda.
If you want to walk with me, my baby, oh, there's land to crawl with me, my baby, oh. If you want to run with me, my baby, oh, sometimes you walk with me, my baby, oh. You want to fly with me, my baby, oh. Sometimes you run with me, my baby, oh. If you want to land with me, my baby, oh. Best have to fly with me, my baby, oh.
I love you, so easy to say, oh. I need you, I hear you plenty to tell. I want you, it be like say we didn't play, oh. But I'll grow with you. Wanna love still. Small, small. I look at your door. I know get up so cold. Make you no focus. We go in lotto. I'll buy you a moto. Before the dodo. Small, small.
Oh, na sene de me ye he swane me ye bad me ye good or the better man me ni kopo mi wo vision be fame wa me pressure na me ye ye be hame classic girl she a boy a landa da obeji ne nya ne joy a kapenta da o chum ne sense koya landa da se me class ni nruya lecture me we ham gari choppa traffic kit na wo home me ti a ma swag to a jari rap a track hit it na me swag lift ya yeah I show you how to party but before then ye me a gari ye mfu ye tro tro ye me a sorry come be baby baby ye my yari kasi ake ka fashe me I say when it sexy eyes, salty to my coma, so now we need my coma name soon. Who needs size? My coma do my family, whom I saw me, whom I come and win me soon. I'm on the rise, my test will get a feature, my lunes will be the biggest that we did. Will you pay the price? My casa, do my
small, small. I know get you though, I know get them so cold. Make you no focus. We go in lotto, I'll buy you a moto before the dundo. Small, small.
That wonderful song sang by Ochiame Kwame featuring Miss V. I love that particular song, Small, Small, Grow Together. Beautiful, beautiful piece by Ochiame Kwame. And this is Good Morning Africa. We're live on Pan-African Television. Make sure that you send us all your views and comments to our WhatsApp number 0560-7421-39. We're also live on Facebook. Link up with us on Facebook, www.facebook.com/Pan-African Television. Let's get interactive on there. You can also like our pictures on Instagram, and of course follow us on Twitter. Connect with us, you know, share with us your views, comments, your thoughts on Pan-African Television, the programs that we have, and of course the topics that we're going to be discussing here on Good Morning Africa. Now I'd like to ask you a very simple question. What inspires you? What inspires you? I'm inspired always by the fact that I wake up every morning, and I'm inspired by the fact that I see people succeed. When I see people succeed, I'm really inspired. When I see people overcome adversity, I'm really inspired. But what inspires you this morning? Well, if you don't know, then I'd ask that you try and understand what inspires you, because I think that is also going to help you inspire others, okay? So let's check out these words of inspiration live on Good Morning Africa, right here on Pan-African Television. We'll be right back after these.
Every day we grow older. Every day we have one less day in our futures and one more day in our past. You can keep doing the old thing over and over and over again. And then in 5 years, you will be about where you are today. Or you can decide today, diamond or nothing, and start climbing the mountain. Instead of walking on the flat ground, you start walking up the diamond mountain. If you make that choice, every day becomes a day when you grow higher and stronger. Every day becomes a day where you look back on the day and say, boy, I did something good today. Then you can sleep at night. The sleep of success.
Don't you feel like there's a lot more we could be doing? Like more quality stuff?
Yeah, dude, this is fucking temporary. I think we signed up for a lifetime in real estate.
It's not temporary. We've always been those guys. I mean, Cole, are we ever gonna be better than this?
Thank you.
word. You will have to change some things in your life. You will have to exercise discipline in your life. You will have some nights when you will be absolutely so afraid that you won't be able to sleep. You will have some days when you will feel so sad and disappointed with people not keeping their promises. You will have lots of problems. But if you are committed, you will learn from every problem. You will learn from every disappointment. Even your fears will make you stronger. And when you become a diamond, you will look in the mirror and you will say, I am so happy I didn't quit. I am the only problem I will ever have. And I am the only solution. All right, I want you to get this in your heads. I am the only problem I will ever have, and I am the solution. Not the upline, not the downline, not the price line, not the company, just me. If I want to be a diamond, it's up to me. If I want diamonds in my downline, it's up to me. I am the only problem I will ever have, and I am the solution. You see, once you believe that, you suddenly believe that anything is possible because it all is up to you. It doesn't take anybody else, just you. When you believe it's out there, when you believe it's out with these people or those people, the upline, the downline, crossline, the company, when you believe that, they have the power and you have no power. But when you say, it's me, I'm the one, then you pull the power into you and anything is possible.
Welcome back from, that wonderful inspirational message right here on Good Morning Africa. If you're just tuning in, we're live on Pan-African Television and you can connect with us on our WhatsApp number 0560-742139. 0560-742139. We're also live on Facebook, www.facebook.com/Pan-African Television. And you can connect with us on Instagram at Pan-African TV. And of course, tweet at us on Twitter at Pan-African TV. Make sure you hashtag Good Morning Africa. Hashtag Good Morning Africa. You can send your questions, comments, and opinions, thoughts, what have you through. I will definitely get a rhythm for you right here on Good Morning Africa. Now, yesterday we studied a lot on Good Morning Africa, and we're taught a lot of the basics in French. Bonjour Kwame, bonjour Ama, bonjour Kobe Pan, bonjour Mr. Mensa, Monsieur Mensa, bonjour Laurence, bonjour Merci, bonjour Joseph Yevo, bonjour Bismarck. All right, so those are the things we studied yesterday, on Good Morning Africa. But let's see what Coco has for us today. It's Everyday French on Good Morning Africa. Coco, let's hear you.
Hi guys, good morning. I hope you're all doing great this morning. My name is Corian Tobacala and welcome to this French teaching segment. And as you already know, I'm here to help you learn and speak French fluently. So today we are going to learn the greetings, salutations in French, how to greet, to check up of people you love, your friends and colleagues in the morning, in the afternoon and in the evening. So I'm going to read. You can just repeat after me or some like to get the accent. So I'm pronouncing words. Bonjour Kweku. Bonjour Abena, sorry. Bonjour Kweku. Comment vas-tu? Je vais bien, merci, et toi? Bonjour Kweku. Bonjour Abena, sorry. Bonjour Kweku. Comment vas-tu? Je vais bien, merci, et toi? It means good morning Abena. Good morning Kweku. How are you doing? I'm fine, thank you. And you? This is in the morning. We use bonjour in the morning, only in the morning. We don't use bonjour in the afternoon. We don't use bonjour in the evening. We use bonjour only in the morning. So if you want to check up on someone in the morning when you go to the office, you can say bonjour, bonjour Alice, bonjour Coriandre, how are you doing? That's it. So in the afternoon, we say bonsoir. So what I wanted to say, like, it's in the afternoon and in the evening, it's bonsoir. We don't have a greetings in the afternoon. We don't have a special greetings in the evening. The same thing, afternoon and evening is bonsoir. Bonsoir Abena. Bonsoir Kweku. Comment ça va? Ça va bien, merci, et toi? If you see here and here, you see a small difference. Comment vas-tu? Here it's comment ça va. It all means the same. It means the same thing. Comment vas-tu? How are you doing? Comment ça va? Is how are you doing too? So you can answer, je vais bien, or ça va bien. The same thing. You can say ça va bien is I am fine. Je vais bien is I am fine. Ça va bien is the same thing. I am fine. Merci et toi. Always say thank you and you. So here is. When you respect someone like too much, or you have a lot, you are not closer to the person, you can just say to the person like, comment allez-vous? Like, how are you doing? How are you doing? And the person will say, nous allons bien, merci. Nous allons bien, merci. We are fine, thank you. Where are you going? Like, où vas-tu? Where are you going? Je vais au travail. I'm going to work. So I'm going to repeat it again, then you see like how I'm pronouncing it, and you can also pronounce it after me. Bonjour Abena. Bonjour Kweku. Comment vas-tu? Je vais bien, merci, et toi? This is in the morning. Bonsoir Abena. Bonsoir Kweku. Comment ça va? Ça va bien, merci, et toi? This one in the afternoon and the evening. Don't forget. Comment vas-tu? And comment ça va? The same thing. Je vais bien and ça va bien. Also the same thing. So there's no difference. You can answer je vais bien or you can answer ça va bien. There's no difference. Comment allez-vous? Nous allons bien, merci. Où vas-tu? Je vais au travail. How are you doing? We are fine, thank you. Where are you going? I'm going to work. So always remember, bonjour, good morning, in the morning, only in the morning. Comment vas-tu? How are you? Je vais bien, merci. I am fine, thank you. Aussi is also, like I'm also fine, I'm also doing well. Je vais bien aussi. Bonsoir, in the afternoon and the evening. Like I said here, we don't have a specific word or a specific greetings to say afternoon, good afternoon, or good evening. It's the same thing as bonsoir. Comment ça va? How are you? Don't forget and never forget. Comment ça va? And comment vas-tu? And comment ça va? Are the same thing. You can say comment vas-tu? Comment ça va? The same thing. Je vais bien ou ça va bien? Je vais bien ou ça va bien? It's also the same thing. So we can't do the salutation, I mean the greetings, salutation in French, without some of the wishes, like what is souhait in French. So to wish somebody to have a nice day, we say bonne journée. Like your husband or your children are going to school and work, you can just wish them a good day, like bonne journée. This is in the morning. Bonne nuit, like have a good night, in the night. Bonne nuit, have a good night. Bonne journée, have a nice day. Bonne nuit, have a good night. So we are going to close this segment. We are going to travel to Côte d'Ivoire to discover La Basilique Notre-Dame de la Paix. In English is the Basilica of Our Lady of Peace. The Basilica of Our Lady of Peace of Yamoussoukro is the biggest Catholic religious edifice in the world. Its appearance reminds us the Basilica of Saint-Pierre in Rome. Located in Yamoussoukro, capital of Côte d'Ivoire, its location has been chosen by the former President Félix Houphouët-Boigny in 1983. But only in 1989 that the Guinness Book of Records recognized the edifice as the biggest in the world. I hope you've learned something today. My name is Coriandre Bakala, and I will gladly meet you tomorrow, the same time, the same channel, Pan-African TV. Au revoir.
It's a beautiful day. I'm gonna make most of it. It's a beautiful day. A day to share with you. You make my world go round, yeah, yeah, yeah. It's really got me saying, nice girl, brings home happiness, brings home happiness.
Experience the wide range of top quality and affordable electronics, phones, tablets, home and office appliances from NASCO. NASCO, bring home happiness.
How much is this?
600.
Wonderful. I think I'll take this one.
But what's your size?
44.
That's 43. I can tell you 44. This is the man, your home of quality shoes from the UK. We have various shoes for the office, for your formal and casual occasions. Visit the man in Abilengpe. Our office is located just behind Aquatech. Our telephone numbers are 020-873-7166. You can also reach us on our landline 0302-730-760. We'll be expecting you.
And I trust that you've learned a lot this morning. You know, this is our own initiative, our own way of, you know, teaching you how to speak basic French. And it's helping some of us recollect the little French we studied back in the day. I recall, je vais à l'école, je m'appelle Kwame Owusu-Danso, pourquoi, elle fait chaud, je suis malade, all those ones. Yes, now I'm trying to, you know, recollect all of those ones, and I trust that it's giving or it's bringing back a lot of memories. You remember when we were back in school, the math teachers and then the French teachers were really tripping us a lot, you know, just so we could grasp the little French. But here we are not going to ship you. You just have to sit, you know, behind your TV, and then you get to learn a lot about French speaking. So the progress and all of that. Now let's zoom in and check out what is happening in the various newspapers we have across the country. Now, let me first and foremost start off with the big story for today. And it's on the front page of the Insight newspaper. You need to get this this morning and read the story, because it's the big story indeed. UN warns of threat of terrorism on regional scale in Africa. And I think this is a big deal. So make sure you grab the Inside newspaper this morning, and then you read it and clearly understand what the Inside is talking about. And we have the pictures of Michael Kwee, Honorable Michael Kwee, the Speaker of Parliament, and Dr. Mohamed Ibn Chambers picture here. And it says Parliament is really in need, says the Speaker. So there you have it. There you have it. Mm-hmm. Yes. Let's move on and look at the Daily Graphic. The Daily Graphic says, big shake-up. And I can see the pictures of COP Dr. George Ekufu Dampare. And I see COP Miss Rose Bio Atinga. And I see DCOP Osabarima Oware Asare Pinkro the Third. And COP Nathan Kofi Buachi. I can see the pictures here. And well, it's saying big shake-up in police. Big shake-up in police. Serve with humility, President tells ministers. Apparently, Miss Utikojaba has been has sailed through. And it raises a lot of concerns, begs a lot of questions to be asked this very morning. So yes, these are the stories on the front page of the Daily Graphic newspaper. Very well. Now let's move on and look at what is on the front page of the Daily Searchlight newspaper. It says, stamp out rot in sports. Stamp out rot in sports. Budget may be read on March 3rd. Budget may be read on March 3rd. Talk first to Rollins, Kwesi Mochi committee told. Talk first to Rollins, Kwesi Mochi committee told. Otiko, 152, NDC, zero. Interesting headline here on the front page of the Daily Searchlight newspaper. Now, let's move on to today's newspaper that says Mahama vacates bungalow. Mahama vacates bungalow. And government kickstarts digital property addressing system. There you have it. Very well. Okay, so we've looked at the inside newspaper already. The Daily Statesman newspaper says current economic woes to go soon, President Akufo-Addo assures. Current economic woes to go soon, President Akufo-Addo assures. And major shakeup in police, Kofi Buachi out of Ashanti region. Rosebio Atinga, now technical. We're going to be looking at its implications. You know, I recall that back in the day, and I recall when I was in a university in Kumasi, we had a lot of armed robbery incidences in Kumasi. But when Kofi Buachi was sent to the Ashanti region, it became very subtle, if you like. It was very quiet, serene, lake of tranquility in the Ashanti region. We didn't really get to hear and see the armed robbery attacks. Let's see if this major shakeup is going to resuscitate the issue of crime rate in the Ashanti region. But that is what it's saying. So there you have it. All right. The New Crusading Guide says, probe 13.9 million VIP Villa saga. Ghanaians demand that there's a probe into the $13.9 million VIP Villa saga. Shake up in police. Bill, I think I moved to technical. It's now official. Mimi Dako is new FDA boss. Sagged police recruit commits suicide. Oh. Oh, yeah. The man has committed suicide. And that story, well, I don't know whether or not it's true, but maybe we're not going to discuss this, but we may read the story. To you, and that story is on page 10 of the New Crusading Guide. There you have it. Very well. Let's move on and look at the Ghanaian Observer that says Akufo-Addo declares war on Galamsey, urges chiefs to join fight. Akufo-Addo declares war on Galamsey, urges chiefs to join fight. And chiefs root for Alhaji Sherif as DCE for Atebubu Amantin. The e-payment evolution in Ghana. That story is on page 9. Awuku confirms refusal of ministerial appointment. And Parliament vets Zongo minister today. Government urged to support technical universities. These are the stories on the front page of the Ghanaian Observer newspaper. All right, the Chronicle newspaper says Otiko sails through after heated debate. And Akoto Ampao is special prosecutor. He also says coffin sellers unhappy with low patronage. Hey, coffin sellers unhappy with low patronage. Why? They don't want people to die. Interesting story. IGP draws his gun, warns public over unlawful seizures. Okay. So there you have it on the front page of the Chronicle newspaper. Very well. The Daily Dispatch says Ghana drops in 2016 corruption index, 70th in the world and 9th in Africa. What is the basis of some of these reports? I mean, send your views and comments to 0560742139. Reports on employment and job creation in Ghana by JSS. And more certified 2016 election results. These are on the front page of the Daily Dispatch newspaper. The Ghanaian Times, Ghana's most authoritative newspaper, says two police commanders arrested for 50,500 Ghana cedis fraud. Otiko Jaba approved by Parliament. We will deal with Galamsey operator, says President Akufo-Addo. President swears in 12 ministers. And that story is on page 16 of the Ghanaian Times newspaper. And there you have them. And there's something rather very interesting that I think we ought to look at, if indeed it's true. Ghana spent $3.1 million at Gabon AFCON. They just ended, you know, AFCON. Ghana spent $3.1 million at Gabon AFCON. Let me ask you a very simple question. And you can also send that through. I'll read them here for you. Do you think it's important for us to spend such huge sums on the Black Stars, you know, when they go out for these tournaments? Do you think we should, the state should spend such an amount of money on these Black Stars players or on any of the national teams to embark on any of the sporting activities across the world? Do you think it's indeed important to do so at this material moment when it appears that we are in a certain economic labyrinth? And, you know, we're spending such huge sums. So that story is on the back page of the Ghanaian Times newspaper. And I'm just asking you this question. Send your views and comments coming in. Let's discuss it right here. The informal newspaper says, approval of Otiko Jaba, Parliament could set bad precedent, said NASPA. But it's not cool. Now it's been affirmed. She's been sworn in. And so it is not about whether or not the bad precedent is going to be set. If that is the case, that, you know, she was passed through not as a result of her not doing a national service, but because the majority in parliament thinks that she's fit for the position, then I think that, yeah, it begs the question of whether or not the floodgates argument will be will be used for any other person going forward. And so, yes, it's a matter of concern. It's a matter of national concern. It's a matter of national interest, public interest. And we need to interrogate further as to the problem this might cause for our democracy going forward. Our work not to make heads roll, says Professor Kwesi Boche. And we'll arrest those who pirate works, says Catherine Afeku. And that story is on the page is on page 5 of the informal newspaper. There you have them. All right. The Daily Guy says, blows over Otiko NDC boycotts. IGP moves Kofi Boakye in police shakeup. VIP's $14 million mansion in limbo. These are the stories on the front page of the Daily Guy newspaper. There you have it. All right. The publisher says, House of Chiefs pledges support for President Akufo-Addo. Esiama shines at Verton, discloses creation of Youth Development Authority. Stay off our land. Aden Dapo, royal family of Dowenya, warns land guards. Let's move on now and look at the Herald newspaper that says Mahama security couples hold keys to VIP villa saga. And Baumia's aide buried without cause of death. Ken Foretta destroys Buache Jako as MPP breaks another manifesto promise. Right. The Herald newspaper. And finally, we'll be looking at the Flex newspaper. The owner of the Flex newspaper happens to be a very good friend of mine, Samuel Bar. Flex, good morning to you. Flex newspaper says, actress Fela McCaffrey talks about ushering agencies. And Kobna Adepa to serve lovers with Makuma Swadie. And Savi saves Takrady showbiz activities. So basically these are the stories on the front page of Flex newspaper. There you have it. Very well. So I'm sure definitely that, you're wondering about the Otiko Jaba issue, the fact that, we need to probe into the $13.9 million VIP mansion saga. Also the fact that we spent $3.1 million on the Black Stars at the just ended AFCON. You'd want to send your views, comments to 0560742139. 0560742139. That's our WhatsApp number. Make sure you send it as WhatsApp and not as a text, okay? And you can also send us a message on Facebook. Go to our Facebook page, like it, and you send us a message on there. We'll get to read it for you right here on Good Morning Africa. And the Facebook page is Pan-African Television. We're also on Twitter. You can tweet at us with all your questions and comments and your views, your opinions, what have you, but make sure you hashtag Good Morning Africa. And our Twitter handle is at Pan-African TV, and Instagram is also at Pan-African TV. So now Sadia and her team are on standby. Let me cross over to the newsroom and so that we can get to hear what is happening in the world of news in Ghana today.
Good morning and welcome to Pan-African News. My name is Sadia Seydu. In the teachers tell Akufo-Addo not to forget his promise to them. 14 NPP supporters over old Fadama clash arrested by the police. Nana Addo influential on social media. Police ready to flash out gunmen along the western border. In business, government must invest minerals revenue in mining communities, says Ghana mine workers. And in sports, Australian football star Tim Cahill apologizes over bizarre red card. Now the news in detail. The Ghana Teachers for Progressive Alliance have welcomed His Excellency Nana Akufo-Addo Dankwa into the high office of President of the Republic of Ghana. Dinah Ejay has the rest of the story.
Teachers are calling on the new Patriotic Party MPP administration to forget the numerous promises it made to them in the run-up 2016 election and work towards fulfilling them without fail. They also reminded the president of his promise to pay in full the salary of the teachers. The teachers reminded the president that over the past years, salary payments have been very clear and prompt. They said they wanted more teachers to own cars, plots of land, houses, and other properties. The teachers also asked the president to ensure that they have the opportunity to pursue further studies in regular programs and to be granted study leave with pay when the occasion arose. The teachers added, and I quote, "We want to plead with you, Your Excellency, to see this as a must for the improvement of teaching and learning in Ghana," unquote. For Pan-African Television, Diana Ejay reporting.
Old Fadama is known to be one of the trouble spots in the country, especially with the violence that greeted it after the 2008 election. Dinah Ejay has more of the story.
The police have arrested 14 supporters of the governing New Patriotic Party, NPP, who are allegedly responsible for the violent clash at Old Fadama in Accra on Sunday. The alleged troublemakers were said to have used machete to injure their colleagues in an attempt to take over leadership of the area. The Greater Accra Regional Police Public Relations Officer, ASP, Efiateng, told Joy News reporter Latif Idrisu on Sunday that the arrest people include 11 men and 3 women. She disclosed that the police command was notified about the clash on Sunday at Agogloshi, a suburb of Accra, and they swiftly removed to arrest the situation. An investigation by Joy News reporter revealed that the most wanted man is Yakubu Alidu, popularly known as Bullet, who is said to be the chief of Takuru in Old Fadama. 3 people were sustained varying degree of injury after the clash and property worth thousands of cedis were destroyed. In an interview, Mr. Alidu added that there was nothing violent about what happened and that there was no need for anybody to panic. For Pan African Television News, Diana Ejay reporting.
The Northern Regional Police Command said it will conduct an intensive operation in the town of Boli to arrest gunmen operating along Ghana's border with Cote d'Ivoire.
The illegal gold mining in small towns such as Boli and Dollar Town have attracted former Ivorian rebels who have mounted checkpoints at some vantage spots to export money from passerby. The PRO of the Northern Regional Police Commander, ASP Ebenezer Tete, said persons in possession of firearms that are not registered are engaging in illegal activities. The police PRO said they would map out a strategy to drive out all persons operating in the community. The reaction of the policemen came on the heels of an investigation conducted concerning the activities of some gunmen operating in the community. The activities of the rebels have become a major concern for the residents, who said they are living in fear. One resident said, and I quote, "Every blessed day of our lives are always at risk because we don't know what will happen," unquote. Another resident described how dangerous the roads were, adding that even though no one has been shot, sometimes fights occur between the Ivorians and the residents. The police commander said they are ready to bring an end to the activities of the gunmen in order to restore peace to the area. ASP Tete said, "The police have conducted large-scale operations before, which have led to the arrest of several persons, including persons who are not Ghanaians." The chairman of the Parliament's Committee on Defence and Interior, Major Retired Derek Odro, expressed worry in an interview. He said rebel activities were a security threat to both Ghana and Cote d'Ivoire because the rebels hold illegal guns and can create a border conflict. He added that the committee would study the situation and call on the appropriate national institutions to address the issue. For Pan-African Television News, Benedicta Isi Apia reporting.
The Ghana Police Service has dismissed about 3,000 new recruits for their failure to present accurate documents. The Director of Public Affairs of Ghana Police Service, Superintendent Sefas Atta, confirmed this development on City News, adding that, indeed, some police recruits are going to be sacked from the police school. He also indicated that they are going to verify and investigate the process until only those who are qualified are called for training. Those who were found to have been entered without the basic requirements have been referred to the CID for further investigations. The list of all expelled recruits from various training schools has been submitted to the police headquarters. Presiding Bishop of Perez Chapel International, Bishop Charles Ajinasari, has noted that fraudsters, thieves, and robbers have craftily found their way into the church. Preaching to his congregation at the Perez Dome, Jowulo in Accra on Sunday, February 5th, the presiding bishop said there are some who come into the church only to steal. Citing an example to buttress his point, Bishop Ajinasari recounted how a married couple in the Perez Chapel International defrauded him and other church members and later bolted to join a different church. Benedicta Apia has more of the story.
He said such fraudsters normally take advantage of their association with the head pastor to perpetrate their crime. Some of them continually shake hands with the head pastor after church service to create the impression that they are close friends, whilst others use photo opportunities to craft that same impression and subsequently exploit it for nefarious and criminal purposes. He said there was the need for the church to expose such fraudsters. Thus, his decision to warn his fellow pastors of the fraudulent activities of the Foster couple. For Pan African Television News, Benedicta Isi Apia reporting.
President Nana Akufo-Addo has beaten off competition from 2015 French runner Kofi Annan to emerge as the most influential public figure on social media Ghana for 2016. This according to data from Ghana social media rankings spearheaded by Advanced Media, Click Africa and Dream Ambassadors Foundation, GH. There's more in this report from Benedicta Apia.
The ranking was based on the Global System for Mobile Co-Communication Bureau score. It was analyzed from the social media following: growth difference, engagements, post-research and mentions. His closest contender, former President John Dramani Mahama, who ranked higher in 2015, also gained new followers in 2016, numbering 713,788, while the former UN Secretary General trailed with 359,951 new followers. The list of the influential public figures is packed for 2016 year under review, with the President Nana Addo-Dankwa Akufo-Addo being in the first place, followed by former President John Dramani Mahama. In the third place was the former UN Secretary General Kofi Annan, followed by the Vice President Dr. Bawud Bawumia, former Vice President Kwesi Emisa Arthur, former President John Jerry Rawlings, and the second lady, Samira Bawumia, in that order. In the year under review, President Akufo-Addo has also gained the highest number of new followers, 935,145, among his competitors, coupled with the highest number of engagements on both Facebook and Twitter. For Pan African Television News, Benedicta Isi Apia reporting.
Up next is Business with Mavis Adamkite.
A very good morning to you and welcome to Business News on Pan-African Television. My name is Mavis Adamkite. Mining communities have over the years suffered from the adverse effects of both legal and illegal mining activities. My colleague Jeanette Notte has more on this story.
The General Secretary of the Ghana Mine Workers Union, Mr. Prince William Ankrah, has made a fresh case for the government to take urgent steps to ensure that the minerals revenue development is strictly invested in mining. The Chief Executive Officer of the Minerals Commission, Dr. Tony Obin, also agreed that the fund should be utilized exclusively for the benefit of mining communities. Prince William Ankrah said government needs to institute measures that would ensure the community's full benefit from the royalties. As part of efforts to mitigate this,